لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله ما لنا رب سوى
لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وخاتم النبيين رحمة الله للعالمين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله سيد الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين Brothers and sisters in Islam, respective viewers, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته and أهلا وسهلا welcome to our program. First of all, we ask Rabbul Izzat Tabarak wa Ta'ala, may Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala make it easy for those on financial difficulties. May Allah grant them barakah and may Allah ease their life. May Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala make it easy for those who are in difficulties. May Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala accept our dua for those who are in difficulties, those who are begging Allah to solve them and fix their problem in their life, inshallah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, once again, we thank you that you're tuning to our program. On behalf of all my friends here behind the camera, we say shukran jazilan that you're always watching our show. And we make dua that may Allah accept the hajj of the hujjaj. May Allah grant him hajj mabrur wa sa'yu mashkur. On behalf of our ITV staff here in Johannesburg, we say hajj mabrur to all our viewers. And please make dua. Your dua is accepted for a long period now. And you are the ambassador of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And may Allah accept your ibadah and may Allah bring you back to Makkatul Mukarrama and Madinatul Munawwara. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we got a very interesting emails and phone calls from our viewers. And I'm very happy this week because I have a wonderful response from my viewers, especially our non-Muslim viewers. They like it. I know they complain that we talk some Islamic terms, Islamic Arabic words. But they met me, and I just want to tell you about my funny situation when we receive a call from a non-Muslim and they ask us about something. And subhanAllah, I don't want to waste your time tonight by talking about my personal incident, but I like you to share with me that is very, very interested. And I'm very happy that we got that calls. So, my friend, I was talking about Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, and you know that I'm a lover of Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab. When I teach the students about Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab, the other class join. They say, no, tell us about that hero or that giant of Sahaba. So one lady phoned and I think she was catching half of the program. She phoned and said, I'm a journalist. I want to interview this man you were talking about. So it was a bit amazing for me to hear that. I told her, you know what we're talking about? We talk about one person who was 1,400 years ago, Sayyidina Umar. She said, oh, what a lovely, give me that book. And this lady, she said, no, I thought he's alive so that I can make interview with him. I said, inshallah, if you become a Muslim, you'll love with him and interview him nicely on heaven, on Jannah, inshallah. We're very proud of our history. We're very proud of our Sahaba. We're very proud of that clean religion, which we can proudly introduce it to the non-Muslim. I'm very glad. And we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he made us Muslim. I'm very, very happy with my full respect to the other religion. But we are very proud of our belief, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide all mankind to the deen of Islam, inshallah. The other thing also, my friend is asking me, we're talking about how to choose his wife, the future wife, you know, that love we talk about. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he encouraged the ummah to double check and choose takhayyaru, you have to select linutafikum, for your offspring. Select a good farm, a good plantation, and wait for the good crops and good harvest. So he said, Iyakum wa khadra'id diman. Be careful, do not marry the green of diman. So now they said, what is that? The green demon. They asked Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what is the green demon? He said, pretty women in a bad environment. That good looking women in a bad family. Why? Because there is something, it's called al-irqu dassas. We are not criticizing, I'm just telling you about scientific fact that people are carry the genes of their family. So before you go and marry, with my full respect to every family and everyone, you have to, and it is your right to check and investigate about the background of that girl. How was her sister? I know that sometimes you find one good person in that family, but it's your right to choose. The main decision, the very serious and dangerous decision after you become a Muslim is to choose a wife. Because talaq is something Allah does not like it. Divorce. We don't want to marry to get divorced. We want to create a small ummah in my house. How I prove that khadra'ud demon, that the influence of the family does affect the boy or the girl or the children. Now the Banu Israel, when they met Maryam alayhi salam, carrying Isa alayhi salam, when she was in mihrab, and you know what they told her? Ya ukhta Harun. Oh, the sister of Harun in Ibadah. A copy, it is not Nabi Harun. And she said, you are a similar of piety like Harun. Maryam alayhi salam is not a sister of Harun. Between Maryam and Musa is 14 generations. It's not sister in Islam, we call it. Oh, the copy of Ibadah of Harun, you're very pious like Harun. ما كان أبوك امرأ سوء وما كانت أمك بغية. From Quran, not from me. They say, from where you got that baby, your father was not an evil doer to do some act like that, and your mom was not that woman of that act. From where you get this thing? That's why when we talk with our friends, they say, Sheikh, my son, I is very naughty. Oh, my daughter, I have 5 children, one is not like us. You see, oh, that one, we're carrying the genetic from one uncle, one auntie somewhere. We say like that. So sometimes don't get surprised. I never done that with my father. I was not like that. He said, yes, because Allah said in Quran Kareem, through that ayah, oh, Ukhta Harun, oh, the pious women like Harun, your father was not like this, and your mother was not like this. So the lady pointed to the baby. The crime itself will talk. The proof of accusation is baby will talk and become a proof of innocent charge. So it's not that he will talk. And he said, قَالَ إِنِّي عَبْدُ اللَّهِ. I am the slave of Allah. Servant of Allah. The first word Jesus said is slave of Allah. Anyhow, just want to prove to you that background of the girl or the boy does affect the marriage. I know some people try to clean themselves, but we're not married to try. We're married to live and to enjoy. So, تَخَيَّرُوا لِنُطَفِكُمْ. Select for your offspring, because al-irq dassas, there is a virus moving from one generation to another generation till you will get it there. So my brother and sister in Islam, we have to choose the deen of the person, the background of the person, akhlaq of the person. Once you get a salih wife, a salih husband, a good husband, now you're getting hasanatul dunya. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana. You're lucky. Anything else can be fixed. House we can sell and go to another place. But mother of my children, that lady accompany me every day, shoulder to shoulder, and sitting, eating. She's my partner even in Akhirah, in Jannah. So we have to select. If you have that pious woman, that you become a lucky person. Now you are a chaste person, you are protected. You don't need. I know some people, Allah, if you give him billions, to marry another and say, no, it's coolness of my eyes. What is coolness of my eyes? It's sufficient for me. I'm happy. And he work with women and he go see the women on the streets, on the malls, never admire this woman and say, may Allah make that one coolness of your eyes. What is coolness of your eyes? You will never. You love that person with his faulty like that. So you see a movie star on TV, you find very handsome man on the street, you know, my husband is a pest. And we did see in our life, women even don't want to marry after her husband, which is allowed for her, but she doesn't want. She said, no, khalas, I want to accompany him in Jannah. So once you try to do a little bit effort, istikhara, istishara, you try to ask, you find out, inshallah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will give you the salih one. Nowadays, the choice of that future husband or wife is, I don't know, it's not according to Kitab and Sunnah. I marry her because she got a green eyes. Now one day the green will become blue. Not everyone can remain the same. Oh, you can buy lenses, you can make for your wife a green. But what about akhlaq and deen? How are you going to buy it? The character and manner. How are you going to buy it? Then Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Fadhfar bi dhati deen." Gain the lady of deen. Taribat yadak. Now you are lucky. You are the winner when you have that lady of deen. Because once the deen is there, the beauty will be there, and dunya will be there, and akhirah will be there. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for our sons and daughters who are getting married. May Allah grant them the coolness of their eyes, inshallah. Short break, we'll continue after the break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brother and sister in Islam. And once again, we thank you that you're tuning to our channel. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide all of us, inshallah, to practice Islam. I'm very, very proud of our daughters and our sons, those who are always asking and looking for guidance. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide all of us. And we always believe that, inshallah, because of the deen of our wives and the deens of our partners, our parents, inshallah, nothing wrong will happen to us in dunya and akhirah. I do believe, and I fully trust Allah tabarak wa ta'ala for what he has said, that inna Allah la yudi'u ajra man ahsana amala. Allah will never make that effort go astray if you do it for the sake of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So we fear Allah, we watch Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's command, so inshallah Allah will look after us. Before the break, I was talking about the importance, how to choose and select, because it's not an individual decision you choose for your family. So the effect of that divorce or the effect of that family fight, you're going to break family ties, you're going to harm your mom, you're going to put your daddy in a very bad situation, your children are going to pick up something from this lady and her family or that man and his family. So our Prophet ﷺ said, select, choose, and ask those who divorce or those who got family fight and marriage fight, what is wrong? He said, there's no chemistry. No, don't say chemistry. There's no deen. We don't run according to chemistry. Deen. If everyone knows the deen, the genetic will change and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it. I just remind you about one incident that one man received a proposal for his daughter. But that boy is very rich, very, very wealthy. So the girl doesn't love him and he doesn't have deen. That boy doesn't have deen. So she said to the father, oh my father, why are you so excited and you want to force me to marry this boy? So the father said, oh my daughter, this family is a family of power and a family of authority, family of money, the family of dignity, the family of what. So the girl cries and said, daddy, you waiting for that to benefit you? He said, yes. He said, that if there is love between me and that boy. But if that marriage goes wrong, what are you going to do now? That authority will be against you. That wealth will stand against you. You can't resist. So you are buying trouble for you. Daddy, let us go to marry the deen one. Why the deen one is very important? When I say deen, it means the person who fear Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Why? He will never, He will never, when he hate this girl, he will never do wrong to her. He makes sarahan jameela. He will fear Allah tabarak wa ta'ala when the time of separation or divorce, it will be according to the kitab and sunnah with muhabbah. That's why we said to the brother, do not force your daughter to marry someone she doesn't love. Try to convince, match, let the people marry according to the kitab and sunnah, and don't listen to that movie and that stories which they rope us and they say love story, love story. If it's a love which please Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and his Rasul, no problem. Another thing also I'd like to respond to our respected brother, that family fight, it should not be there at all. Relatives, because we believe that the entire ummah are family. Don't worry about the language, don't worry about the color. The entire ummah is one family. Once that person read La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, become my family member. Innama al-mu'minuna ikhwa. Indeed, the believer are brothers. So, ikhwatun, ton. You know, when you read the Arabic, you see ikhwatun with a close ta marbuta, is a biological brother. Ikhwan is figuratively, but I'm talking about ikhwatun. Leave that ummah now and talk about our immediate family members. Brothers, brother. Biological brother from the same father and mother. I don't want to repeat the story of Nabi Yusuf alayhi salam, the children of Yaqub alayhi salam. I'm talking about why the brother gets stuck. Number one, and I have to be very straight today. Number one, dead brothers, they marry a wrong person, the wrong girl. That wrong girls come to the family. Family is running nicely, business together, they living together, loving each other. And then you go and choose the wrong one. You remember when we say about selection, how to choose. You bring a dirty girl, corrupted on the mind, live on jealous and malice. She enjoy to cause a problem. And you bring her to that clean family, a decent family, a peaceful family. From grandfathers and mothers, aunties, they never have any problem. Then this girl, she was playing on the street last time or last week. Now she come to become a lady of the house. No problem. And then she's tried to cause a friction, cause fitna and facade in the family, instigating, pushing something and cause a friction. And mom don't talk to the son. Son treat mommy bad. And that family story, which me and you, we know very well. And it's happening there. Why? Because this uncle, he claim that he love his wife, don't want to offend her, and go abuse his mother. Oh, that lady doesn't know what is birrul walidain, the piety to be kind to the parents, and she doesn't know the seriousness of disobedience parents, to become unkind to your parents. She claimed that she loved that boy. But if that boy get burned, she ran quickly to get some medication or something to heal that or to cure that type of burning. But she's sending the same person to Jahannam because mother and parents. So why our brothers, we got some problem? Because there is outsider come and cause. He never did not make a proper agreement. Look here, I'm mommy's child, straight. A mommy child. That issue is a red line. They call it red line. No, don't talk about my mom and my dad and my family. My deen and my mom, that is out of negotiation. So from the first day she married, or before married even, she knows that this one here is very sensitive. I don't open it. But the problem is that man opened the ears for this lady, give her a chance. He talked bad about his brother, but now that lady. This is the first one. The other thing, we must not forget that nafs, that our nafs, that evil in ourself. وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. That, what you call, that I, that nafs. What is that? Yes, you have something in yourself, it's called nafs, doesn't like harmony, doesn't like peace. Not shaitan, nafs. So it's like a virus. You're born with it. It's genetic. Right. Not iblis, not shaitan. No, not shaitan. They said, all right, if Iblis causing that problem, and then who caused Iblis not to worship, not to make sajda to Adam, and they don't want to obey Allah Ta'ala? Iblis lamma ghawa man kana waswasahu. Please, when he disobey Allah, which Iblis was pushing him to? No, it's called inside job. Nafs. So he reject the command of Allah because of jealous. Right, he was very good before. And another thing also, it's called hasad. Like that, we said to the parents, stop raising children in front of one another. You're causing, you're activating and you're exciting that jealous in the heart of the children. This is the only son. I love this boy more than I'm going to stay with you. No. You tell him separately. Don't tell him in front of one another. I know many mothers, they're going to laugh now. Qabil and Habil. Qabil and Habil, the two children of Adam alayhi salam. Adam alayhi salam gave authority to Habil because he was very good and decent, not troublemaker, to look after the Adam's belonging till Adam alayhi salam go travel and come back. Now Qabil said, I'm an old elder. Like what's happening in our community now? Why my younger son do that? Where's the respect? Anyone can lead, no problem. As long he got that capability, he know how to manage it. Then Allah tested them for Qurbani. Allah accepted the Qurbani of Habil, didn't accept Qurbani of Qabil. So Qabil said, La aqtulannak, I will kill you. Why? What did I do? He said, no, Allah accepted your Qurbani. You went for Hajj, me, I don't go for Hajj, I will kill you. He's like that. So why you are pious, half is the Quran, I'm not, I will kill you. He's jealous, envy. So the main problem also amongst the fraction amongst the brothers is hasad, the inside job. So we have to deal with that. And inshallah, we're going to make a special program about how to avoid hasad. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, may Allah clean our heart and purify our nafs from that evil, inshallah. Short break, we'll continue after the break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brothers and sisters in Islam. And once again, we thank you that you're always watching our show. On behalf of my cameraman, all my young boys behind the camera there, we say shukran jazilan. May Allah make it easy for us to practice the teaching of Allah and His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Before the break, I was discussing the cause and the reason why there is a hasad, why there is a friction, why there is conflict between a real brother, biological brother. We did talk about the ummah at large, but we're talking about the family now. We're talking about the hasad, the envy. That hasad here, it's everyone who got it. Everyone who got it. But someone activated, someone just kept it quiet. So hasad, you can make hasad for your own self. And I forgot to tell you about Nabi Yusuf alayhi salam and his brother. Why did they throw him in a well? And they make story of the wolf and what. This is hasad. Yaqub love him more than us. So that's why again I'm repeating, stop raising one child in front of the other child. You're causing too much problem. Even you think that you create some competition. No. Not from the mother and father. Big problem. You're creating a big problem in front of, even in the teacher, the teachers in the class, or the manager in the company, when he brace someone, they run after him and try to dirty his name and try to compete and put him down. It's like that. So the other reason also, they call it hope in assisting, raising hope for help. My own brother don't want to borrow me money. I call him, he didn't answer. The nikah of my daughter, my own brother didn't come. I was sick, he did not visit. Yes, they call it tama'ul ma'una. Tama'ul ma'una, it's the raising hope that this, the only one who can run to me first, is my own brother. يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيَّهِ. On the day of Qiyamah, the brother ran away from the brother because the first one, we wait to help and he got capability and power to help is my brother. Maybe my father is sick, who old, who doesn't work anymore, my brother. So they call it tama'ul ma'una, the greed or hope to gain the assessing of the brother. And half of our problem with our family members and our relatives is just because he never called, I was sick, he never invite me for wedding, is like that, because we don't expect that it can happen from my own brother, and the one who can harm me is my own brother, and it become a big shock. You, I accept the outsider, but you do that for me. That's why Allah ask us to join the family ties so that we can switch off that hasad and that evil, and we can gain the safety and security from our flock, our immediate relatives. Another cause of that friction amongst the brothers, as the ulama said, it's called we inherited from our parents. You have no problem with anyone, then mommy instigate, daddy talk till we break ties with our cousins, because his father didn't help his father. Now, what about the grandchildren? Never see that grandfather that time. You say, no, they come in India 100 years ago, there was we had a farm day. No, not like that. We talk about now. Why you die and you leave sayya jariya for you, that you leave some evil behind you. No, especially the stepbrothers or that lady married, and then it happened to my own family. I don't want to talk about my family in on TV. I got one uncle married another, my own uncle married another lady. And then it was many years ago. Now that the youngest child of these two ladies is 50 years. The youngest one, last born. Now these ladies for 35 years, they don't talk to each other. And then they never ever, when the uncle passed away, they don't even attend the funeral together. They make two funeral day. So it's a inheritance. The lady tried to push to say, why you marry my husband? Why you are the new one? You are the invaders. You're the one who attack. You steal my husband. But khalas, once that lady married, we've got so many of emails, and the people say, Sheikh, make dua that my husband can divorce the other one, the new one. They say, no, you can't make this dua. He's a wife. Which dua? I say, Allah, let that man divorce his halal wife. We can't do that dua. Khalas, married. She become a wife. Got a children. Finish now. Make sabr. So they call it the inheritance of the problem. We inherited from our family. Another thing also, we did not teach our children the acceptance of apology. Sorry, finish. We call him al-wadud. Wadud, it means once the person apologizes, finish now. If you really have a clean heart, you don't keep it in a storeroom. إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. You just meet Allah with a clean heart. Teach the children, you must accept the apology. Don't keep it and raise it again on other problem. So the other thing also, as we said last time, that tahrish. What is tahrish? Instigation. Friends, family, outsider, they try to, why this family are happy, we not happy. So it's hasad as well. So that one they call it tahrish. Don't listen to the outsider. Your brother is first. Don't listen to the friends or the outsider. Why you are working together? Why like this? You must break up. You must separate yourself. We have to. Nowadays is a style to have union, to unite yourself. Countries, they make union. African Union, European Union, Business Union, Trade Union, Soccer Union. Now for you, you don't want to you disunite. It's a style nowadays is to unite people. We have one friend of mine was very clever. He tried to dig down to know his entire family. I don't know, I'm not allowed to mention that family. Every Eid, they call, I don't know how many. The hall is full of the children. And then you say, come and see Sheikh. This is my auntie, this is my grand. They don't know each other. And then they brought them from the entire of South African provinces and come stay together. And they go for holiday together, three buses. I was so happy. You see, yes, back to union. that واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا. This day of Eid become a very special day of Eid. You get these people, they apologize to one another, they greet one another, and then it was a good chance for marriage and to know each other and to support one another. Imagine this family financially united, spiritually united, dini united. They will be very powerful family. That's called i'tisam. So sometimes the tahrish, people like to disunite the ummah. Another reason is shaitan. Shaitan make adawa between the children of Adam. So they cause a friction, cause disunity, that between Banu Israel, children of Yaqub alayhi salam, they become, create a baghda, malice. We already have that jealous in our heart, but he excited. Shaitan build it up and excited. Another thing also, mother and parents, they spoil their children till turn to become serious. You just shout your brother and shout your sister, and you think that your brother is going to overlook at it and forgive you. Yeah, when you were young. But now this man is a husband of someone, father of some children. He got his own dignity. He got some position. He's working on a decent job. So he not allowed you to embarrass him in front of the public. So now this brother is no more like that young one used to hit him and abuse him. No, you must give him full dignity. Not only brother, any human being is the first priority in Sharia is to protect his honor. So now you think that your brother is going to swallow that. Yes, he swallowed that in certain age, but he got children, you got wife, you got mother-in-law, you got his in-laws with him. No, you have to respect. You can't use that thing as a joke and then turn to be serious. No, we're not allowed it. Then, a fake competition. That competition. Yes, we have to make munafasa. You have to compete for khair, not for shar. Now, the competition, your brother bought double-story house. And that sister-in-law said, oh, and what about you? They went for holiday. You don't go. That's called fake competition, which is very bad. Create enmity till you wish for your brother not to have any khair. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save our heart from any jealous and malice, inshallah. They ask me to stop for a short break. We'll continue after the break. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, brother and sister in Islam. And once again, we make a special dua. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite the heart of the ummah, unite the heart of all human beings, unite the heart of the family members. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unite the heart of ulama and our Muslim leaders. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for each and everyone to fulfill the right of Deen al-Islam, inshallah. Before the break, I was talking about that reason or the cause of that friction about or between our brothers and why the family nowadays is not united, which not all of them, we don't generalize, because I did see here in South Africa and out of South Africa a very united family, and I'm very proud, and we make a special dua. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring the muhabba amongst the family, and we will be united in Jannah. So it's better to be united here so that we don't have any problem on the day of Qiyam. The other reason I was talking about it before the break, it's called that unfair competition. That competing is ni'mah. You try to do better and everything is ni'mah, but to change it to enmity, you change it to malice and jealous, no, that is going to turn haram. Then you compete for the sake of Allah, no problem, but to start to harm that person, start to put obstacle and block his way from progressing, no, that is a crime. That is not allowed in Islam. Another cause also for that, some sickness, it's called suspicious. You're suspecting people. Some person is a suspicious person. You just think bad about everyone. This is a psychological problem. This. Always negative. Someone pass, And then he never greet you. Because he is very arrogant. Not like that. Maybe he was something, he was thinking, we give excuse. We try to create some excuse. Not everything, it's against us. Not everything happened, it's planned against us. No. Who are you? Who are you to expect that everyone in the community hates you? Everyone in the community doesn't love you? No. It's impossible. Al-khayru fiyya wa fi ummati ila yawm al-deen. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the goodness is going to be on me and in my ummah till the day of Qiyamah. You can't. So, inna ba'da dhanni ithm. Some of that suspecting or that doubt you have is sin. Because maybe you are not in the mind of that person at all. He doesn't mean it. No, she saw me but she never greet. He didn't attend the janazah of my father or my uncle. He did not know. And you try to find out the excuse because really some people are innocent. We just suspect them. We just expect that you're going to do something when not everything you feel is going to happen. That is a very important husnul dhan. Think good. And you're going to have some thought of peace in your mind. This is not one running after you. No, you think good. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, talking about raib. Raib, it means you try to create some negative doubt. No, we always think. You people say, look at half of the cup, or I don't know, the full one, or what they say that saying there. But everyone is clean, is innocent, till we have a solid proof that he's accused, or his victim, or his criminal. They say like that. So they say, no, if people are three type of people. Number one, he's older than me. He's better than me. Why? Because he was baligh and yeah, in this dunya before me, and he knew Allah before me. So he's better than me. All right. Maybe he's younger than me. Also, he's better than me. That is husnul dhan. You expect good. You think good. Positive. Why? Because I'm older than him. It means I commit a sin before him. So I was a sinner before that younger one. So I cause a problem to Allah before that person. So he's better than me. But if he's equal, if he's the same age like me, also he's better than me. Why? Because I know what I have done, but I don't know everything about him. So according to the scale of mine, good and bad, me, I'm worse. Because I don't know all the secret of that person. Maybe he did not do what I have done. So I'm a guilty. He's not a guilty. Brother and sister in Islam, yes. Muslim, always. The asl of everything is tahara. You just find the carpet is tahir. Tell someone tell you is impure. That water is clean. Tell someone tell you, or you see the solid proof that is in. But the asl, the main, the obvious things that everyone is innocent till you bring the solid proof. So, stop to implement that sickness in your heart to suspect people or to accuse people. Another thing also, reason of that disunity is the kibr, arrogant, pride. Yes, why this man steal the show? They call it steal the show. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one man came and said, Ya Rasulullah, annas, people, madhuhum zayn wa dhammuhum shayn. People, when they praise us, oh, they make us high. And when they criticize us, they put us down. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, no, la, ذَلِكُمْ هُوَ اللَّهُ. This is only Allah can do that. So let the people praise me as they like. They will never elevate me. They will never. They give fake praising. Right? And then let the people criticize me. They will never drop me because Allah wants to elevate me. So he said, no, don't wait for the people to make you up or to put you down. When they praise you, you think that you put you up? No. Now you got kings and presidents. They got an army of media behind him. Once he drop, they turn against him. They turn against him. So it's like that. So, just think that you are just a normal person and we don't need to implement that arrogance or that pride, or you try to make yourself superior. No, we Muslim should not have kibr at all. That لا يدخل الجنة من كان في قلبه مثقال ذرة من كبر. No one will enter Jannah if he has a size of an atom of pride in his heart. In his heart, not on action. Because kibr, that arrogant, or that pride, causing enmity. If someone just walk in certain way, so causing a problem now. Or someone just make himself superior, or he just elevate himself like that. But the problem is, someone is called istakbar. What is istakbar? Made himself big, but in reality he's not big. So someone acting like alim, but he's not alim. So that one is a bit funny, we feel sorry for him. Someone is very weak, and he feel that he's very strong, and he got fitness, and he got physically strong. My friend, must know your qadr, your value. You must make estimation, or what you call estimate. So what I'm trying to say, you must adjust your value. You must know who you are, and khalas. Another thing also, Nabi Muhammad SAW said, man tawadha lillahi rafa. Anyone who lower himself, Allah will uplift him. By certain incident, you will see yourself flying. Yes, from Allah, that is halal now. Another reason of that, they call it, you're not discussing some issue comes in your mind and your heart against your brother. You just leave it like that. So someone doesn't greet you, you keep that feeling in your heart, you don't discuss it with him, you don't confront him and you try to tell him what you feel. See, yesterday you passed me and you did not greet. You say, wallahi, I was thinking about my daughter, she was in the hospital, and I was, oh, sorry, my friend. Like that. So you try to clean and try to wash all that problem day by day. Some people just isolate themselves, they get cross, and you got something on the heart you don't want to discuss. Husband and wife like that, they don't discuss that matter together. That's why that virus is growing, till it become a big problem. So this one, they call it, don't discuss that matter with the brother. You must. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in one incident, that one of the Sahaba, after Salah, immediately didn't make khatam of Salah and Sunnah, and he left the Salah after Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam make salam, salam alaikum, and then he left the mosque. So it happened in one Salah, second Salah, third Salah, second day. So Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam did notice that. Why this man just finish his Salah and walk away and run out of the masjid? That it teach our Imam and our father and manager, you must check your flocks. Our Nabi, masjid was full, but he noticed that one man jump after Salah immediately and run. So one Salah, he catch him, he say, Azuhdam fina, you don't like me. So he said, Ya Rasulullah, I got secret, I don't want to tell you. But if I keep that secret, you're going to think bad about me. Let me tell you that secret. I'm very sorry that man told me I have to stop. Inshallah, we'll continue next time. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the unity and love, inshallah. Till we see you, inshallah, next time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, ma lana rabbun siwa.